Teresa, my final question for you is, as an HR person, as a recruiter, how can they use the emotional intelligence in their recruitment strategies or when they are interviewing people? What can we learn from the EQ of ourselves?
There's a few different strategies that can actually be applied for HR in recruiting and then keeping your top talent. We want to find the best and we want to keep the best,
them, yes.
Right? Because I mean, you can look at probably the past 10 years of HR reporting and it will show the top three problems HR has been trying to solve is keeping their employees engaged, hiring the top people, keeping the top people, and then managing through change in the business. They just jockey for position a little bit. So we still haven't sort of cracked the code on that one. And emotional intelligence can be really helpful because it can be used in a few different ways. One, in the interview process, or even if we want to come to like screening a resume.
Yeah.
Are people, are candidates even including this in their resume? Are they including an EQ profile? Are they including EQ learning as part of their like, oh, look, this person has worked with an EQ coach on their emotional intelligence. Are they including it, number one? Because I mean, candidates that realize its importance will put it on their resume. The second thing we can do in interview processing, I think it's kind of funny that we ask sort of behavioral event interview
questions. Tell me about the time.
Tell me about, yeah, exactly. That's it. And everyone has prepped for these. I can only imagine being in recruiting and just being like, here comes another answer. How can I even, how can I trust it? Right? Such a good question. So it isn't the question itself. For sure, we can change those. There are ways to make them more emotionally intelligent directed questions, but the probing questions you ask after they respond are ones where you can harness your power and knowledge around EQ to get to the, did they actually do this? Can I trust their answer? So, you know, questions around, what was it that you felt in that situation? So you're asking them a feeling-based question.
Oh, wow.
How did you know that's what you were feeling? So you want to hear, I get this physical signal. So how did you know you were frustrated? I get a physical signal when I'm frustrated, a little lump in my throat. And now, you know, yeah, this person is speaking the language of emotional intelligence, which means the recruiters have to know what that language is. So, I mean, in recruiting, it would be good if, you know, they picked up a book on emotional intelligence or took a few courses on emotional intelligence.
Hired
an EQ expert to come in and consult and teach you how to do it. That's another way of doing
any
it.
Any book that you can recommend or you have in mind?
Well, Travis Bradbury's, I keep my EQ books right by my side. Travis Bradbury's book, Emotional Intelligence 2.0, is probably one of the easiest books to sort of absorb what EQ is. Now, the one that I practice myself is called The EQ Edge, and this breaks emotional intelligence down into 5 realms, 15 skills.
Wow.
Now we're getting into, can I quantifiably measure your EQ? Yes, you can. It's insanely expensive to hire people in leadership roles and executive roles. So in recruitment, you spend a lot of time and energy looking for this next leader or executive. And if they don't pan out, sometimes you'll have spent tens of thousands of dollars to recruit them that just goes down the drain. Well, profiling for EQ in the interview process, I strongly recommend organizations do that for their leadership and executive roles, because you will know in advance or can figure out in advance which EQ skills are the most valuable to this particular role. And then you can run your assessments on the individual and use their profile as part of the hiring process.
Thank you for sharing that, Teresa. And I believe every recruiter or HR person will benefit from this. And with that, my interview with you comes to an end. Again, thank you for taking the time to ask you this good question, which I believe my audience will benefit from. And again, for the audience watching or listening, please leave a comment below, like and share the video, reach to us through our social platforms, and tune in tomorrow, not tomorrow, another week for a great interview that I'm preparing. Teresa, again, it was nice talking with you. Keep in touch. Bye.
Thank you.